Good morning. Welcome to the Ward Scott Files, News Radio 980 and live on the internet, newsradio.com, wardscottfiles.com. Yeah, there was a special meeting of the county commission at 1:30 in the afternoon, ran about 3 hours, and about 2 hours and 45 minutes, something like that, into it. You hear some amazing conversation by Hutchinson about penalizing deputies for arresting people for pot. And we're going to play this extensively in the second hour and talk about this. But Ed has not heard this. Ed was not aware of this as the mayor of Gainesville. Ed, we're going to give you a special screening. Go ahead. Have you got it set up, James?
Okay. Well, I thought it could be handled just by talking nice to the sheriff. So I did that the first year. Second year, we did a little budget adjustment based on the fact that she was uncooperative. I don't know what I'm going to do this third year in the budget, but got to be something. What I really want is the deputies to hear, sorry you didn't get your raise because you're busting people.
I don't think it's
stop at the street level. They got to quit busting people.
Well, there you are. We're going to run that a little bit more, and Ed has not heard that. He could not
that
even imagine
stunning.
That kind of conversation.
That is stunning.
Now, that is your county commissioner, okay?
Oh, my gosh.
Verbally, out loud, in a meeting of a public meeting, getting ready to go after the deputies on the street for doing their job. Now, you tell me what Black on Black Crime Task Force told you guys.
Well, I mean, the Black on Black Crime Task Force was really started many years ago. It's been going on and has great participation, and it's concerned largely with the behavior of youth, and some of the crimes that take place, in an effort to, one, get kids channeled in the right direction, young men in particular channeled right direction, and to make communities safer. And so and I don't have the data right in front of me, but I can just say, I can say factually that when you see arrests made in predominantly minority neighborhoods, what are called minority majority neighborhoods, the calls that go to police that result in the arrest, the calls originate from that neighborhood, from the Black neighborhoods themselves. And so it's from people who want their neighborhood to be safer. And so the idea that the deputies are just sort of rolling through neighborhoods looking for young folks to arrest is really, I think, out of line. Well, one, it's not substantiated by the facts, and two, it's really out of line to threaten their pay, essentially, or an increment in their pay based on that. And it's pretty shocking.
Okay. Well, I thought it could be handled just by talking nice to the sheriff, so I did that the first year. Second year, did a little budget adjustment based on the fact that she was uncooperative. I don't know what I'm going to do this third year in the budget, but it's got to be something. What I really want is the deputies to hear, sorry you didn't get your raise because you're busting people.
Well, I don't
it's got to stop at the street level. They got to quit busting people.